Right now, there are a few themes hotter than the unstoppable ascension of the data center. As more and more companies embrace cloud computing, they need somewhere off-site to store all of its information technology equipment, hence the growing need for these huge warehouses full of hardware and software. Which brings us to CyrusOne. The symbol here is CONE, C-O-N-E, a data center real estate investment trust that provides mission-critical facilities to nearly 1,000 customers. Here's a stock that's already rallied nearly 25% year-to-date. I bet it's got more room to run because this is such a fabulous growth story. Plus, CyrusOne reported a strong quarter earlier this month, and the company pays you a bountiful 3% yield. So let's take a closer look with Gary Wojtaszek. He's the president and CEO of CyrusOne. Find out more about how his company's doing, where it's headed. Gary, welcome back to Mad Money. Good to see you, sir. Have a seat.
Thanks for having me, Jim.
All right, so I had this theory I'm going to bounce off you. The dividend is really just kind of ice cream here.
That's right.
All right. And what's amazing to me is if you weren't a real estate investment trust, we want that obvious pass through.
Right.
But it's also a cohort. You're just being pulled down, if anything, by the whole cohort.
Yeah. Well, you know, it's an interesting company. You know, we are a real estate trust, so we do trade with that.
But I think you want that.
But what you're seeing more and more of, though, is a rotation out of some of the traditional asset food groups within the real estate sector and into one that's growing.
So okay, good.
We grow 5-6 times faster than the typical REIT does.
All right, because the reason I point that out is because someone might say, well, wait a second, 3%, that yield is not that great, but this is a growth stock that gives you a 3% yield. Those are hard to find.
Yeah, it's a dividend play with a value story attached to it.
Now, you say in your conference call, you say that that when people understand your story, they realize there's no need for them to stay in this data center business any longer. Have you been able to convince some of the big builders of data centers, some of these companies, that perhaps you should just take their sites over?
Oh, yeah, without a doubt. I mean, our success has been in the enterprise space. So traditional brick and mortar Fortune 1000, we've convinced all of them to give it up and outsource that to us. In the last 2 years, what we've been really successful at is convincing the largest cloud companies in the world to also outsource it. And that's been all the growth we've had in the last 5 quarters has been driven by the growth in cloud.
Now, I noticed the churn's down substantially since I've seen you last. So that means people recognize this is the best way to go.
Yeah, we call it the Hotel California effect. Once they're in, they stay forever.
Now, are there still some independents? For instance, if I go to Alphabet, to Google site, they're so proud of their data centers.
Right.
They give you a virtual tour of their data center. It seems like they may be wedded to the business.
Yep. You know, I think for the time being, maybe that might be the case, but more and more are not choosing to build their own. We have 9 of the top 10 largest cloud companies as customers, and we expect that that's going to continue to grow over the next decade.
Now, I saw that you took a giant piece of land in Washington, the state of Washington. I can't necessarily presume that that's going to be for Amazon, but I have to presume that you have enough customers that it's going to be able to be immediately filled.
Sure. So Quincy, Washington has the lowest power rates in the country.
Is that because it's hydro?
Yeah, hydro. And so it's green. It's a great green story and really cheap. But, you know, it comes down to dollar and cents. And, you know, the cost savings from having a data center here for like a 20 megawatt customer versus up there is about a $20 million difference in electrical savings.
What's the friction? In other words, if you build all of your sites there, what does that mean? I mean, to me, I would say to myself, wow, I can do nothing but hydropower, but you need to be closer to some of the other, in Chicago, you're in Texas, Virginia, you can't just put it all where
everything is application driven. So there's some applications that don't require a high degree of latency, and those applications are going to go in low cost environments. So if you think about any of the storage applications that you may have, storing photos, videos, you don't access that too often. And those types of applications could be house in low-cost environments, as opposed to ones where, a fast trading environment where you have to be right next to the data center and the matching engines or in Jersey over here.
Right, because, we have data centers for Wall Street
where
they can't afford to be even a millisecond later. That's not this kind of case.
No, but we actually own that one. So,
you do?
So we acquired the Chicago Mercantile Exchange's data center a year and a half ago. So we actually have, all the forward contracts are basically going through our facility in Chicago now, in Aurora, outside of Chicago.
When I look at it does seem like the growth has accelerated. I'm wondering whether that isn't people who recognize, we really have no business being in this business, and these other guys really know how to do it.
Yeah, that's absolutely the case. I mean, typically what we've seen is we could deliver a data center for, 25% of the price of what a traditional
25% of the price.
25%, and it's 50% cheaper from an operating
cost. So if you're a public company, you can immediately raise your margins.
Absolutely.
Well, this is a pretty easy story to me. That's Gary Wojtaszek. He's the president and CEO of CyrusOne, symbol C-O-N-E. This is a growth stock that happens to be a real estate investment trust. Mad Money's back into the break. Booyah! Jim Cramer here from Mad Money. Thanks for watching CNBC on YouTube. Click here to subscribe and get the jump on my exclusives with CEOs, plus market news, investing advice, and a whole lot more.